flag is taking me forever. Hello, my name is Betsy Ross. I was born on January 1st, 1752 in Philadelphia. I was the eighth child of 17 children. My parents were strong believers in the Quaker religion, which mainly focuses on peace and friendship. Because of this, my siblings and I attended a Quaker school. We were taught basic life skills such as reading and writing. My aunt also taught me how to sew. After school, my father apprenticed me as an upholsterer, which is a person who works with cloth. Soon, I met the love of my life, John Ross. We helped across the Delaware River, where we were married in a tavern. My mother and father never forgave me for it, and I was banned from the Quaker Church. Eventually, John and I opened our own upholstery shop in Pennsylvania. That's where my sewing skills came in handy. One day, we went to a new church where we met General George Washington. He asked me to sew the new American flag. It took many days and nights of hard work, but I finished in 1776. The day came, though, when John was fighting in battle, and he died after a gunpowder explosion. Soon after that, I became a patriot icon in the 19th century. Even though John died, I kept up the upholstery business and kept sewing. Soon, I married once again in 1777 to a man named Joseph Ashburn. He was a sailor and we had two children together. Sadly though, while he was sailing on a ship across the sea, they were captured by the British and he was put in prison. He died while he was there. Time passed, but I kept working. I married once more in 1783 to a man named John Hancock. He had known Joseph while they were in prison together, but he escaped. We met while he was delivering me my mail. We had five daughters together. After 34 years, he died after a long disability. In 1810, I sewed a garrison flag that was sent to New Orleans and 27 more flags that were sent to the Indian Department. In 1827, I retired from the flag making business as my eyesight was getting worse. By 1833, I had gone completely blind and decided to spend the last 3 years of my life with my daughter Jane. I died on January 30th, 1836, at the age of 84.